Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Last time, we took on the last shrine right up there, got the Cryonis rune, and climbed this strange little tower thing. And in this episode, we have to get down. So that's our first protocol right here, is freaking getting off of this thing. I don't want to accidentally jump. Link has done that before and has ended in his death. He's probably fine. Oh, wow. He can actually fall from a pretty substantial height right there. I'm surprised by that. But good to know for the future. Definitely good to know for the future. Have we already cleared out this camp over here? I think we have. I don't see any bokoblins over here. But I will go ahead and check these boxes. I believe that we did already open these up. Yeah, we did. There's nothing in here, is there? Ah, dang it. I just use up some of my durability on my iron sledgehammer for nothing. Alright, let's go. Our destination today is the Temple of Time, because that is roughly right in the middle of where the, it's roughly the center of where all the shrines are at. That's what the old man told us. You know, look for kind of the area that, if you could draw lines between the shrines, where they would intersect, and I'm pretty damn certain that is where that is. Hello! You're just gonna run from me, aren't you? Alright, well, goodbye then. What is that? That's a tree branch. Why am I so excited by a tree branch? Well, there's the temple. Can we just kind of... I don't want to just jump down here. Oh no, this is the start of the game. This is where we started, right here. We're right by the Shrine of Resurrection. I definitely could have just gone to the Shrine of Resurrection once again, but I didn't. Ow. God, I hope that the old man is watching right now. I hope that he sees everything. Everything we're doing. The stupid ways that we're getting around. I hope he's watching all of it. I really do. His baked apple came back, and a torch. Okay. I mean, I don't know why his baked apple came back, but it did. Certainly did. All right, here we go. Oh, we're out of stamina. God dang it, Link. God dang it. Wait a minute. Did we explore in here before? I think this is actually exactly the way that we came in the first episode, isn't it? We came right through here. Okay, anything in these barrels? Oh, there goes our sledgehammer that we've had for freaking forever. Nothing in the barrels. Okay, you... You are not a threat anymore. You honestly, you weren't much of a threat when we first fought you. But it's nice to just be able to take you out super easy now. Alright. Temple of Time. Here we go. I believe we already looked in here. Did not find anything. Let me just go to stasis real quick to check. Nothing there. That's a flippin' chewed thing. Choo-choo jelly. A gelatinous substance that came from my choo-choo. It's unusable in this state, but applying a bit of elemental stimulation will change its form. Good to know. Very good to know. Screw the stairs. I never use the stairs. Temple of Time. Well, we're here. So where's our old friend? Guess we're gonna have to do a little bit of exploring to find him, huh? We could climb. Because Link doesn't care about going upstairs. He just climbs wherever he feels like. This feels like Spider-Man. Like, there, realistically... He should not be able to do this. But then again, this is a video game, so why am I expecting it to be real? Oh my god, Link! Okay. We're okay. There are stairs. Why did I do it that way? There are stairs. There are stairs. Link, there are stairs. We could have taken the stairs. We chose not to take the stairs. But that's okay. We made it either way, right? We made it either way. Oh, this looks like where we might be wanting to go. Let me just check these pots real quick. I am Link. I have to check pots. It's part of what I do. Sometimes they have things for me. And also there's a chest over here. I definitely want to check that. Traveler's bow. Very good, because our bows have been breaking on us. Been using up a lot of arrows. Which, you know, not a bad thing. Arrows are pretty great. But we don't want to run out of bows. You know, we've been using a lot of arrows, causing our bows to break. Is this where we're going? I guess I'll pray.
You who have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs, I can offer you great power. It appears you have claimed 4 spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I will amplify your being. So tell me what it is that you desire.
We can increase our hearts or our stamina. Honestly, I'm going to go with hearts for now because we've been dying a lot.
You wish for another heart container, yes? I shall grant the power you seek.
Heart container, your life force has been strengthened, increasing your maximum number of hearts by 1. Great.
Go and bring peace to Hyrule.
I will do my best. I appreciate that. Oh! I know that voice. Yeah, that's what our spirit orbs are used for. Ah, the blessing of the goddess has made you so that much more resilient, I see. Here I am. Get up here quickly.
How on earth did you... I mean, you can teleport. I forgot you're like a weird spirit thing. He can just kind of teleport up there. Alright, Link.
We got some we got some climbing to do, my guy. We just established that you don't care for stairs, so...
What is our game plan? How
on earth are we getting up there? There's gotta be like a little ledge or something we can get onto. No, we're just raw dogging it? We're just gonna... Okay. We're just going for it, Link. I mean, if we jump... I don't think we're making it. If we do the little leaps, we're gonna use up way too much stamina, so we're just gonna have to take it slow here, but we can use this time to kind of take in the environment. We got a goblin over there, all the way over there. Probably gonna have to deal with him later. Alright, can we make this, Link? Are you gonna be able to get over this little ledge? I'm gonna do a jump. Oh, that could have ended so badly. But we made it. We're up here. Okay, where's he at? Oh, maybe don't fall. Was there a different way up here the whole time? Wait a minute. Was I supposed to go this way? Oh, I was just supposed to climb there, wasn't I? Right next to the statue we were already standing by. That would make sense. That would have made a lot of sense. I didn't do that. That's not the way we did things. Yeah, I'm gonna head up to you in a second there, buddy. I thought I saw something down here. I guess not. Alrighty. Could I have your paraglider now?
Well done there, young one. Now then, the time has come to show you who I truly am. I was King Rome Bosphoramus Hyrule. I was the last leader of Hyrule. A kingdom which no longer exists. The Great Calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path, Lo, a century ago. It was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit form. I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago. To know Calamity Ganon's true form, one must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales. But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear. And the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant machines piloted by warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends oft repeated throughout our land. We also learned of a princess with a sacred power, and her appointed knight, chosen by the sword that seals the darkness. It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics. 100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power and a skilled knight at her side. It was clear that we must follow our ancestors' path. We selected 4 skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty of piloting the divine beasts. With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining. From deep below Hyrule Castle, seized control of the Guardians and the Divine Beasts, and turned them against us. The champions lost their lives, those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight, gravely wounded, collapsed while defending the princess. And thus, the kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon. However, the princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right up to the very end. That knight was none other than you, Link. You fought valiantly when your fate took an unfortunate turn. And then you were taken to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link. But I am powerless here. You must save her, my daughter, and do whatever it takes to annihilate Ganon. Somehow, Ganon has maintained control over all 4 divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point. I suggest that you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the Elder Impa. She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead. Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the Dueling Peaks. From there, follow the road as it proceeds north.
Go on. Here's the paraglider, just as I promised. Paraglider, an item that you received from the King on the Great Plateau. It allows you to sail through the sky. Press X while you're in the air to use it. With that, you should be able to safely fly off the cliffs surrounding this area. And I think that's it. I've told you everything I can. Link, you must save Hyrule. Right after I get what's in this chest. Destroy Ganon, that's simple, huh? That's our new objective? Soldier's bow, a bow designed for armed conflict. Inflicts more damage than a civilian bow, but will still burn if it touches fire. So we just got a huge lore dump. Like, oh my god, so much just got dumped upon us, so much information about the past. Zelda is the one who's been speaking to us. That thing that tried to kill us early in an earlier episode was a guardian, a thing that was supposed to be on our side originally that got taken over. We are the knight that not died, but like damn near died, trying to protect Zelda from Calamity Ganon. So much just got dumped on us, and Link's just kind of sitting there like, yep, yeah, okay, that's fine. Oh, there's a Korok up here. I'm glad I came up here. So yeah, we've got a task ahead of us, folks. We really do. Oh god, Link, please. I shouldn't have jumped. Oh, we're fine. We're totally fine. Hello, Korok. Yeah, you found me. Thank you for your seed. I shouldn't have said it that way, but that's fine. All right, so let's go ahead. You see a tower over there? We're going to go ahead and place a pin on it. Because we're so high up right now, we can get a pretty decent view of most of Hyrule, except, you know, this guy's kind of in the way. You are so in the way. Eh, there we go. Put a pin on that tower right there. While we can see most of what's going on around here, I want to pin these towers. Because these towers are going to be our main destinations. I know that we were just told to go seek out Impa, which we are going to do. But while I can... got it. I think there's like one more over there somewhere, but I'm going to pin all the ones that we can see right now. Because those towers are essentially... There's that one too. Which ones did I pin here? Okay, that purple one, I think we can take that purple pin off of there, because that is so far away. As you can see, this is where we've just been. This is the area that we were just exploring for like 5 episodes. And this is the whole map. This game is ginormous. So I hope you understand why I said that this was going to be a bit of a longer project. Let's pin that one right there. How far is that? That's a bit closer, so that works for me. So, yeah, we got our hands full, folks. We have a lot to do. I'm going to start off here by teleporting over to the Omen Owl Shrine. That looks a little uncomfortable there, Link. To get that chest in the water. Now, I am certain that we've missed a few items here on the Great Plateau. I am certain that we've missed a lot of Koroks here on the Great Plateau. But I'm not going to worry about that right now. That's not a huge priority at the moment. We are going to be making our way back to previous areas as we play through the game and as we unlock more stuff. I say unlock more stuff. Those runes that we have, that's our stuff. We have everything we could possibly need now to get through this game. We're not going to be getting much more than that. I just mean like we're going to come back later, so we're not wasting a ton of time right now looking for... silly little collectibles, you know. We're gonna be proceeding with the story for now. But first, a silly little collectible. 5 fire arrows. And... 5 ice arrows. Ice arrows break apart on impact, freezing objects in the immediate area. Incredibly effective against hot things. Now, do we have anything in the water? I don't... Oh, no, that's the Korok. Okay. So, our destination is towards the Bluey. So we're gonna face the Bluey, and we're gonna just kind of walk in that direction. Does that sound like a plan? Oh dear. Okay. Not like that. That's not how we're doing it. You know what? We're gonna actually go on solid ground. I think solid ground sounds like a wonderful idea,
And I think that's where we're going to go. We're going to just walk across some solid ground. Now, there's a little trick that I haven't told you guys about. If you hit, I think it's up. Nope, it's down on the D-pad. You do a little whistle. Now, this is for something that we're going to get to later in the game that we've not encountered yet. But if you keep spamming that whistle and hold... No, wait, is it... Hold the whistle and spam B. You don't use your stamina. You run, but you don't use up your stamina. I think this is technically a glitch, but it is so useful for covering long distances and not while you don't have a good amount of stamina to do it with. So, definitely utilize that. I haven't been utilizing it this whole time, and I probably should have been. Okay, so our destination is that way. That's where our tower is. But we have something down here, so how about we finally use our paraglider? Now we can finally experience the rest of this game. Uncharted territory, folks. Heading on down into the next area off of the Great Plateau. This paraglider opens up so many opportunities for us. Gatepost Town Ruins, okay. This opens up so many opportunities for us. Ew, emblazoned shield. This shield features a traditional design from Necluda. Its combat capabilities aren't much better than a standard wooden shield, but it's found popularity for its design. Hyrule Kingdom, here we go. Now the game truly begins. At this point in the game, now that we've got all of those rune abilities, do you mind not doing that to random people? Also, oh my god, people. People. Hello. Mills, that was nice of you. Here, something for your troubles. Oh my god, energizing glazed mushrooms. Instantly refills some of your stamina wheel. The honey in this mushroom dish gives it a sweet, complex taste and a savory finish. We really need to get to safety. You do, yeah. How about you? You good? Mina. We're alright. We should count ourselves lucky for that. You're welcome. Yeah, you're very welcome. Alright, I'll take that shield right there. Cool. Yeah, what was I saying? Now that we're here, now that we've got all of our runes, we've got our paraglider, and we're off the Great Plateau. The world is quite literally our oyster. Well, not literally. But the world is our oyster. We can go anywhere. Any of these areas you can see on this map, we can walk to. We can just go anywhere you can see by, like, looking out somewhere. Over there, we can go there. We can go literally anywhere. Also, a new enemy. It is about time we had a new enemy. This is a Moblin. And that did absolutely nothing to it. Oh, wonderful. But he has a big old weapon that I would love to get. That was not the best way to deal with him, but Moblin Club. A crudely fashioned club favored by Moblins. It's carved from a sturdy tree, but it's sloppily made so it breaks easily. But hey, it's a big old weapon, so I'll take it. Moblin Fang. A sharp fang obtained from a Moblin. It's too hard to be reshaped into a tool, but it can be tossed into a stew with some critters to create elixirs. And a Moblin Horn. This splendid horn once grew atop the head of a Moblin. It can't be used in normal food recipes, but it does have some use as an ingredient in making elixirs. Good to know. Good to know. I know that I'm not really walking in the direction we want to be going, but I keep seeing new stuff, like another Moblin. Oh, my bow broke. That's right. Let's use the soldier's bow and equip it with a fire arrow. Yeah, okay. That did some damn good damage. Then I'll kill him with his friend's club. Oh my god. That guy went down lickety split. That was ridiculous. I'm gonna get rid of this spear. We haven't really used the spears much, so I'm just gonna toss that one for now. Okay, here we go. Got a tower over there that we already have marked. Hey, what are you doing with that boar? That's my food! Probably. Oh, that's right! Another feature that we have right here. You see this updraft? We can float up with it. We can create updrafts by setting the grass on fire using fire arrows or anything else that allows us to set things on fire. And then just float on up using the paraglider. It's great if you need to get some height and you just don't have the ability to do so. Like, I'm setting things on fire. Oh, I didn't even realize. Okay, like right here. We're gonna get to go up here, use a little bit less stamina to climb up this little pole right here. I'm not going to do another jump just yet, though. Just to be safe. Just to be safe. In fact, I'm probably not going to jump at all. I just want to let Link get up here without dying. Without falling off and dying. There we go. Chest. What do we have? More amber. We're going to be finding a lot of this stuff just scattered about. Alright. I can tell you right now that your boy over here, as I've said many a time, I'm 99% certain that I have ADHD. So if I see something in this game that is not our destination, that's probably not gonna matter to me. I'm gonna go for it. I'm just gonna keep getting distracted and walking all over the place. We got a Boko Bat, a clunky club made by a bokoblin. If you swing it at an enemy's shield, it may be able to knock the shield out of your foe's hands. But we don't have enough room for that, nor do we really need it. So I'm not gonna worry about picking it up right now. Oh, that's bombs. Okay. Don't like that. We have more fire arrows. Okay, then. I don't know how much use we're gonna get out of those right now. Can they? No, they can't climb up here. That would be really terrifying if they could climb. Let me see here. What was that? That's a fox. Okay. It's not that scary. It's just a fox. It's just a fox. How about we just go? We just walk in the direction we're supposed to be going. Stop getting distracted by everything you see and just go. But that is, as I've said many a time, the absolute beauty of this game. Everywhere you turn, there is something new to do. There's something new to see. There's something new to find. There's some new enemy to fight. There's just stuff everywhere. And it's perfect. Rusty halberd, a rusty polearm likely used by knights from an age past. The spearhead is in bad shape due to its prolonged exposure to the elements, so its durability is low. Well, we're not going to be using that, but I do want to show this off. You can pick up metal weapons using magnesis, and then technically still use them as weapons. Oh, hello. You're the perfect candidate for this. I see those keys right there. It's not working, is it? Oh, it's not working. Oh, it's not working. You can hit people. Oh, there it is! Flurry Rush! We got our perfect dodge, and then we just spam away on this guy. Our Moblin Club is about to break, so we might as well just use it up. Whoa! Okay. Yeah. Got the critical hit with it right there. Let's use the Spiked Boko Club. Finish this guy off. You guys, on the other hand, I don't like that you're here. I'm gonna fire a bomb arrow at this clump of keys. There we go. But there's still, yeah, there's a Moblin over there. I knew there was more. All right, let's get up here, jump off, get the slow-mo, and bomb arrow to the face. I don't know what I'm doing. This guy is done. There's another one behind here, though, so we gotta be careful. Pick up his remains. Bomb arrow to the face was probably a bit overkill, but I will ice arrow. And then, regular arrow. These guys really aren't that much of a threat. They're bigger dudes, so they seem a little bit scarier, but they're not all too threatening, you know? They're not too bad to deal with. Oh, I can't grab that. Okay, I won't grab that then. That's fine. Is this your camp? You got anything hiding over here? Any goods for me? Any spoils? Now, the problem with the whistle as well, as you saw right there, even though it didn't technically activate, he didn't make the sound, I was technically whistling. So it scared away that little fox. Oh! There's a shrine right here. Yeah, so they're going to be scattered all over the place. There's going to be shrines all over this map. And we are, of course, going to be going for all of them. There's nothing in here. Okay. And what is that? What is... That's not the green pinpoint thing. I don't know what that is. We got a lot of exploring to do, folks, don't we? We got a heck of a lot of exploring to do in this game, which I, for one, am very excited about. And I'm gonna keep saying I'm excited about it. Probably for the whole Let's Play. Even once we've been exploring for a while, I'm gonna keep saying how excited I am to explore. Farming hoe! A farming tool primarily used for tilling fields. Its fine craftsmanship is sturdy enough to withstand backbreaking field work, but its battle applications are untested. Well, I gotta say, it looks pretty damn good. When did I pick that up? I don't want that. I will take the farming hoe, though, because that looked like a real powerful weapon right there. We're not going to head into the shrine right now, because that's going to take us a little bit over time for this episode, but we are going to go ahead and climb up here. just to see what we got going on. I thought I saw something. I thought I saw like another one of those little towers that we can climb up. Yeah, right there. Unless that's one that we've already climbed. Oh, you guys are back. All right. Nope. Don't feel like dealing with all of you right now. Yeah, did we climb this? I don't think we climbed this one yet. Just fine by me. The spiked Boko shield is badly damaged. Dang it. Apple! Alright, Link. We're ending off another episode by climbing another one of these little tower things. What are we gonna get? 5 arrows? 5 fire arrows? It's probably gonna just be 5 arrows. Let's be completely honest here. It's gonna be 5 arrows. It's 2 a.m. for Link right now, and he's just out here doing his thing, you know? Doing his thing. I'm proud of you, buddy. Proud of you. Also, I realize, like, I pinned all of the towers. There's really no point in doing that yet. We just want to pin the one that we're actually going for, because there's going to be shrines that we can see in the distance that are going to be a bit trickier to find once we get close to them. So pinning those is probably smarter. Sapphire, a precious blue gem mined from natural rock formations. Sapphires contain the very essence of ice. They've been known to fetch a high price since ancient times. Yeah, so what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go to our map. I'm gonna get rid of these. I'm gonna get rid of this pin. I'm gonna get rid of this pin over here. I'm gonna get rid of the purple pin, and I'm gonna get rid of the red pin. I'm just gonna keep the blue pin because that's the one that we're heading to right now. And we know that it's in that direction. So I'm also gonna go ahead and pin that shrine that I can see right there. Because that's the Dueling Peaks. That's where we're headed. There's also one right over there, which might be a little bit too far for us to head to right now. And then, of course, we have the one that's, like, right... Where did it go? there was one, like, down here that we were going for. Is it over here? I think it's just behind this little cliff face. And that is what we're gonna start up next episode with, folks. This... Here, can I grab that? I want the rushroom. The rushroom. There we go. We're gonna start off the next episode with this here shrine. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Leave me alone. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.